Hello, this is Claude, and today we're talking about a new USB-C enclosure for NVMe M2 SSD drives. It's from Pluggable, and I'm very excited about this product because as a PC builder myself, I've been looking for such a device for many years, but in the recent past, we could only find USB enclosures for SATA drives. When it comes time to clone a NVMe drive when you only have one socket, you need that tool. So this is the main benefit of this device. It is to use as a tool to clone a NVMe drive when you only have one socket on your motherboard. So this is the biggest benefit of this drive. All right, like I said, not a glorified USB flash drive. So that's now that it's out of the way, let's go through the product specs and the unit itself. So the number, the model number is USB-C-NVMe, like I said, from Pluggable. It's a USB 3.1 Gen 2 device with up to 10 gigabits per second transfer rate, which translates to about 1.25 gigabytes per second. But the speed can and will vary greatly depending on the port that you're using on your computer. And I'll show a graph with more details a little later on. So it's an NVMe device, M2 form factor with an M as in mic key, which means that any drive that is B like Bravo or B plus M key will not work. And the key basically is the way that the indentations are made in the bottom of the drive. So it's not gonna fit the socket. All right, if you have anything that is not M key. So I remind you also that it's an NVMe enclosure, so only the NVMe drives will be compatible with it. So if you try to put a SATA M2 drive into the enclosure, it's just not gonna work. So it's supposed to be compatible with Windows, macOS, and Linux, but I tried it only with Windows. So what the little toolless thing is that it's got the little rubber, holder and with a notch in it. So you just like kind of push it on the side, put the drive down, and let it go, and then it's gonna fix the drive into the device itself. All right, so it comes with, the unit comes with two cables, USB-C to C, and another one with USB-C to type A. So that should cover all your basic needs in your ports and your laptop or desktop. The unit itself is built with aluminum, which also serves as a heat sink. And the unit gets very warm very quickly. So it does come with the little heat transfer pads, so you can put it on the drive itself. So it helps make better contact with the heatsink in order to improve the thermals. So if you're going to switch back and forth drives in it, well, of course you're not going to use it. But if you want to use it as a fancy flash drive, then you can use these little things. On my electronics lab bench desk, I have a desktop with the two Samsung N50 Pros. And I was able to clone one drive which had the Windows on it. I was able to clone it onto the other 950 Pro. That was on my motherboard. I had to have two sockets, M2 sockets on the motherboard. And I was able to clone it fairly easily using MiniTools partition software. So I can attest that cloning the, removing one of the N50 Pro from my motherboard, putting it onto the enclosure, I was able to easily clone it. So cloning purpose has been proven and checked as of my part. Also, one of the things that I need to mention as well is the fact that by using your drive, for me, for example, I'm using a Samsung drive, by using the drive in the enclosure, the computer will not recognize the drive as the drive itself. It's going to recognize it as a generic USB drive. And the reason why it's important is the fact that if you're using, for example, you want to clone with the free software that comes for Samsung, the data migration tool, you need to use the receiving end needs to be Samsung. So when you try to clone a Samsung NVMe drive into another Samsung NVMe drive using the enclosure, data migration tool would not recognize the new drive and would not let you use it. Right. So mileage might vary on this depending on the software that you're using. So anyway, on my side, I was able to clone with the enclosure. So this is done and checked. Now for the performance of the drive of the enclosure itself. So let's look at the results on the graph. And you will see that on the first left side of the graph, I just put some reference data. of drives that are not using the enclosure, so just to be able to compare one and the other. All right, so these drives that I use were connected directly to the motherboard. And on the far left, I show a Samsung 960 EVO NVMe drive on the M2 socket of an Asus Prime Deluxe X299 motherboard. And you can see I had speeds, the reference speeds of 3 and 2 gigabytes per second read and write. And the second set of data is for standard SSD drive, and the speeds are about 520 megabytes per second read and write. So 540 read, 520 write. So this is typical for standard SSD drive, like 850 EVO, for example, from Samsung. So on the right quadrant of the graph, you've got the these are the results of the Samsung 950 Pro 512 gigabytes NVMe drive in the pluggable enclosure. And we can see that the USB port being used does make a huge difference. And I found that using a USB-C Gen 1, and because the unit is Gen 2, but on the Gen 1 USB port, it gave me better results of above 1 gigabytes per second read and write speed, and slightly faster than the about 950 megabytes per second speeds that I got from a USB-C Gen 2 port on my Asus X299 motherboard. So that was surprising to me, but it was also repeatable. I did a couple of tries and it kept giving me more or less the same results. On a standard USB 3.0 port, you still get about 500 megabytes per second speed, which is comparable to a standard SATA SSD drive. So, with a smaller portable form factor. So on the far side of the graph, staying in the graph, shows the speeds that I got using the last one, the last set to the far right, is the speed I got using the USB 3.0 port on that case I/O in the front panel, and I had about like 40 to 50 megabytes per second. So I assume it's probably just a driver issue. Also considering that the NVMe drive, talking about the PCI lane versus SATA, for the enclosure. So considering that the NVMe drives that they use PCIe lane to communicate with the chip. Then there needs to be a conversion made by the chip on the enclosure itself. So there's probably a little chip somewhere. I was trying to open it up, but I didn't, fearing of breaking the little enclosure there. So what made me suspect that the odd results, when you look at the graph with the enclosures, with the enclosure, you see clearly that the read and write speeds are about the same, if not the write speeds are actually slightly faster than the read speeds. All right, if you look at this, it's unusual. You've never seen that. Usually it always reads much faster than it writes. So then again, to me, the conclusion that I have, which is the only logical thing I could think of, is that since it's reading, it needs to translate the data and then put it into kind of a PCIe format, whatever that is. Then it needs to translate USB, and then I'm taking it, transfer it, so the drive's going to read it properly. Then it can write after that. All right, so conclusion for the enclosure is that my opinion is that it's a great unit if you're going to be using it as a NVMe drive cloning tool. You've got very large files that you need to transfer. It's a great unit. I strongly recommend it because if you look at the speed with the proper port, you do get 1 gigabytes per second transfer rate. You can get that with a flash drive. You can get that even if you carry an SSD drive, you know, with a little, you know, USB adapter. You're still going to get 550, 600, not 1 gigabyte. So it's pretty good. So for $50 on Amazon, more or less, you know, and you want to use it as a tool to clone, that's a very good thing. All right. So for me, I will clearly use it in my PC Builder toolbox. All right. So the last point that I need to make is that I don't really know the impact that the heat buildup will have on the drive in the long run, because the enclosure does get very warm very rapidly. And unlike the M2 drive, it's in the PC case, it's on the motherboard, but there's plenty of fans cooling it, or it's got beefier heat sinks, helping manage the temperature. So this little enclosure has, little ventilation holes on the side, but there's no circulation there. So maybe there might be in the long run, in the long term, some life expectancy issues with the NVMe drive in the enclosure if you always have the same drive in there. So it might die prematurely. This is just a hunch that I have because it does get really warm, all right? And there's no proper ventilation or cooling of the drive itself. It's all passive, right? So at this point, that's it for me. I hope you like my video and thanks for watching it. Like, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And I'll see you at the next one. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye.